All right, y'all. Peace and blessings. God bless y'all. I'm Jarvis Kingston. I hope y'all doing all right and staying solid in these times that we're in. I hope that things in your life are improving daily. I pray that your relationship with the Most High is getting better. I pray that you take it day by day and that things get a little smoother for you in these crazy times that we're in. Now, today I want to discuss about, you know, waiting on the Most High, waiting for the Lord to do things for you and working while waiting on the Most High. You see, when it comes to waiting on the Most High for things, whether it's something you prayed for or something you've yearned for, or had a desire for, we have to remember that the Most High gives us the desires of our hearts, and it has to be according to His will. When we have these things we want out of life or these things that we want to get done, we can't just do it for our own personal reasons. We can't just have our own intentions and selfish ambitions about it. Everything we want out of life or desire has to be based around the will of the Most High. It has to be based around benefiting us, and also has to be based on helping others around you with it. You know what I'm saying? Helping others with what you're praying for as well. And at times we become too much of a narcissist or too selfish and always demand things and want things and have a sense of entitlement. But we have to remember it's not all about us at the end of the day. It's all about the Most High. It's all about the kingdom of heaven. We have to remember that. So when you're waiting on the Most High, you have to be in position for it as well. You have to be in alignment as well. You have to be consistent with what you're praying for. Your heart has to be in the right place. You have to have a good foundation and a good reason for why you're praying for the things that you're praying for. And if you're waiting on the Most High for certain things in your life, you have to be better in your character along the process. You have to go through the trials and tribulations prior to that prayer request as well. You have to also really want to position yourself for it too, because a lot of times when people hear waiting on the Lord, you're not supposed to just sit there and then, you know, just wait for him to do it. It doesn't work like that. When you're waiting on the Most High, you're still active and working. You're still diligent. You're still vigilant while waiting on the Most High to come through for you. You could be in the midst of your situation and still wait on him to come through for you and deliver whatever he has towards you and to answer your prayer requests. You get what I'm saying? You have to also be at the right place at the right time. You have to also be working hard towards it as well. Because remember, faith without works is dead. Okay, so if you're wishing and desiring all these things and your works don't back it up, or if you're not in alignment or position to do it, then it won't fall through. You get what I'm saying? So we have to do everything in decency and order. And we also have to be consistent with what we're praying for. Like, we can't say we want something and then we're doing a total opposite of what's needed. You get what I'm saying? So everything has to check out in order for things to be fulfilled and come through. All right. So I just want to read some scriptures about waiting on the Most High and the beauty of it and just go from there. The book of Psalm 130, verse 5. I wait for the Lord. My soul does wait. And in his word, do I hope. The book of Isaiah, chapter 8, verse 17. And I will wait for the Lord, who is hiding his face from the house of Jacob. I will even look eagerly for him. The book of Psalm 25, verse 21. Let integrity and uprightness preserve me, for I wait for you. The book of Psalm 33, verse 20. Our soul waits for the Lord. He is our help and our shield. The book of Psalm 25, verse 5. Lead me in your truth and teach me, for you are the God of my salvation. For you, I wait all the day. The book of Psalm 130, verse 6. My soul waits for the Lord more than the watchman for the morning. Indeed, more than the watchman for the morning. The book of Psalm 52, verse 9. I will give you thanks forever because you have done it. And I will wait on your name, for it is good in the presence of your godly ones. The book of Psalm 40, verse 1. For the choir director, a psalm of David, I waited patiently for the Lord, and he inclined to me and heard my cry. The book of Psalm 62, verse 1. For the choir director, according to Jeduthun, a psalm of David, my soul waits in silence for God only. From him is my salvation. The book of Psalm 62, verse 5. My soul waits in silence for the Most High only, for my hope is from him. The book of Isaiah, chapter 26, verse 8. Indeed, while following the way of your judgments, O Lord, we have waited for you eagerly. Your name, even your memory, is a desire of our souls. The book of Isaiah, chapter 33, verse 2. O Lord, be gracious to us. We have waited for you. be their strength every morning, our salvation also in the time of distress. The book of Isaiah, chapter 51, verse 5. My righteousness is near, my salvation has gone forth, and my arms will judge the peoples. The coastland will wait for me, and for my arm they will wait expectantly. The book of Psalm 69, verse 3. I am weary with my crying, my throat is parched, my eyes fail while I wait for my God. The book of Psalm 59, verse 9. Because of his strength, I will watch for you, for God is my stronghold. The book of Micah, chapter 7, verse 7. But as for me, I will watch expectantly for the Lord. I will wait for the God of my salvation. My God will hear me. The book of Genesis, chapter 49, verse 18. For your salvation, I wait, O Lord. The book of Psalm 119, verse 81. Calf, my soul languishes for your salvation. I wait for your word. The book of Mark, chapter 15, verse 43. Joseph of Arimathea came, a prominent member of the council, who himself was waiting for the kingdom of God, and he gathered up courage and went in before Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus. The book of Psalm 119, verse 43, and do not take the word of truth utterly out of my mouth, for I wait for your ordinances. The book of Psalm 119, verse 74, may those who fear you see me and be glad, because I waited for your word. The book of Psalm 119, verse 114, you are my hiding place and my shield. I wait for your word. I wait for your word. The book of Psalm 119, verse 147, I rise before dawn and cry for help. I wait for your words. Hallelujah. So it's important, man, that we keep waiting on the Most High, y'all. But we also have to be in position and alignment for what we're waiting for in certain aspects of our lives. And we also have to be consistent. And the works have to back up our faith, okay? So let us, the Most High will always do his part, all right? The Most High, he keeps his promise, he protects his people, he keeps his covenant. The Most High always does his part. We as people, we have to hold ourselves accountable and do our part. We stay steadfast, we stay prayed up, we stay strong. We keep bettering ourselves, we keep improving ourselves, and we keep working on our character and keep, you know, having more endurance and building and strengthening ourselves and being more better people. All right. Why would you want the Most High to give you all these things if not even bettering yourself or not even trying to better others around you? All right. So let's keep waiting on the Most High for everything in our lives. All right. And let us keep working towards the Most High forever. And let us also, you know, stay in alignment and stay consistent, stay on that narrow path. All right. So I just want to remind y'all how great the Most High and his Son is and go from there as we close out. Hallelujah. He is. Hold on. Hallelujah. Amen. He is the Adam, the Advocate, the Almighty, the Alpha and Omega. He is the Amen, the Apostle of our profession, the Arm of the Lord, the Atoning Sacrifice for our sins, the Author and Finisher of our faith, the Author of life, the Author of salvation, the Beginning and the End, the Beginning of creation of God, the Beloved Son, the Blessed and Only Ruler, the Branch, the Bread of God, the Bread of Life, the Bridegroom, the Capstone, the Captain of Salvation, the Chief Cornerstone, the Chief Shepherd, Christ, Christ of God, the Consolation of Israel, the Cornerstone, the Counselor, the Creator, the Dayspring, the Deliverer, the Desire of the Nations, the Door, the Elect of God, Emmanuel, the Eternal Life, the Everlasting Father, the Faith and True Witness, the Faithful and True, the Faithful Witness, the First and Last, the First Begotten, the Firstborn from the Dead, Firstborn over all creation, the Forerunner, the Gate, the Glory of the Lord, God, the Good Shepherd, the Great High Priest, the Great Shepherd, the Head of the Church, the Hearer of all things, the High Priest, the Holy and True, the Holy One, the hope of glory, the horn of salvation, the I am, the image of God, the Jehovah, Jesus of Nazareth, Jesus, Judge of Israel, the Judge, the King Eternal, King of Israel, King of Kings and Lord of Lords, King of the Saints, King of the Ages, King of the Jews, the King, the Lamb of God, the Lamb of God, the Lamb without blemish, the last Adam, the lawgiver, the leader and commander, the life, the light of the world, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the living one, the living stone, the Lord, Lord Yah, Yahuwah, Yahweh Shai, Yahweh Be Yahweh, Ahaya Yeshaya, Yeshua, our righteousness, Shalom, Barakatha, Lord of all, Lord of glory, Lord of lords, man from heaven, man of sorrows, mediator of the new covenant, the mediator, the messenger of the covenant, the Messiah, the mighty God, the mighty one, the morning star, the Nazarene, the offspring of David, the only begotten Son of God, our great God and Savior, our holiness, our Passover, our protection, our redemption, our righteousness, our sacrificed Passover lamb, power of God, precious cornerstone, Prince of Kings, Prince of Life, Prince of Peace, the Prophet, the Redeemer, the resurrection and life, the righteous branch, the righteous one, the rock, the root of David, the rose of Sharon, the ruler of God's creation, the ruler of the kings of the earth, the Savior, the shepherd and bishop of souls, the Shiloh, the Son of David, the Son of God, the Son of Man, Son of the Blessed, Son of the Most High God, the source of eternal salvation for all who obey him, Son of Righteousness, the Just One, the One Mediator, the stone the builders rejected, the true bread, the true God, the true light, the true vine, hallelujah, the way, the truth, and life, the wisdom of God, the witness, the wonderful counselor, the word of God, the word of life, the word, the truth, the way, the life, hallelujah. Yes, yes. How awesome is he, right? How awesome is the Most High and his Son. Let's keep waiting on the Lord. Let's stay patient. Let's stay diligent. There's certain things in our lives we've been waiting on the Most High for a good minute. Certain things we waited on the Lord in that instant moment when things got a little hectic and crazy. Certain things we waited on the Lord within a certain day to happen or a certain week. Hallelujah. Certain things we waited on the Lord to happen within a month or certain months or a certain timeline. Certain things we waited on the Most High some for years. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That beautiful patience. Been waiting on certain things in our lives for years. All right. But his timing is better than our timing. If we had got what we wanted or requested or desired within that moment that we wanted, it probably would have hurted us or destroyed us or hindered our relationship with the Most High. Or, you know, things probably wouldn't have gone in the greatest direction that we thought it would have. You see what I'm saying? When you give things, great things take time. We have to build up our character in that due time. You see how that works? So that way, when we receive it, we'll know what to do with it. We'll know how to handle that blessing. We'll know how to, you know, still stay true to the Most High and still be able to function, right? Because you don't worship the blessing. You don't worship the creation. You worship the Creator. Hallelujah. You don't worship what's prophesied to you. You worship the Most High. You don't worship things and people and situations and moments. You worship the Most High only. He gets all the glory. He gets all the praise. He is a jealous Creator. And we have to always remember that and respect that. Hallelujah. So whatever you've been praying on and waiting for the Most High on, keep working towards it. Okay. And let it be for the Most High's will. Let his will be done. It's not about your will and your ambitions and your intentions. It's about his will. All right. So there y'all have it. I pray to God that whoever listens to this message, I pray that you get baptized and you start your life for the Lord. I pray that you have excellent patience. I pray that you have excellent work ethic. I pray that your works are honest and pure. I pray that you build up your character. I pray that you build up your endurance. I pray that you increase your patience. I pray that you increase your hope. And I pray that you pass that on to other people. I'm Jarvis Kingston. I got much love for y'all. I hope your relationship with the Most High gets better. I hope that your life will change day by day. I pray that you stay on that narrow path. Peace.